Tomorrow, those who care about politics will finally get to cast their votes, as will 23 million other Australians. Useless buildings like schools and churches will be transformed into democratic super hubs, but more importantly, barbecues. Australia has had a record 8 weeks to look at the candidates. To put that in perspective, at the start of this campaign, Australia was still known as Gondwana Land. Yet, even with 8 weeks of window shopping, the polls show Australians still haven't figured out which candidate they want to be cut down within 18 months of winning office. But while the polls are undecided, we do know one thing for certain. By the end of Saturday night, one of these men will be in the lodge, while the other will be comforted by their wife, Chloe Shorten. To help Australians decide, the nation's newspapers have published editorials endorsing the candidate of their choice, an endorsement which could sway the votes of the 12 retirees who still read newspapers. The Age, Sydney Morning Herald, Daily Telegraph and Herald Sun all endorse Malcolm Turnbull, while news.com.au have backed Chewbacca Mask Lady for PM, and the Daily Mail thinks it's time to put Kendall Jenner's side boob in the lodge.
But I know what you're all wondering, who does the feed endorse? After a campaign like this one, there's only one candidate Australians can feel proud to put down on the ballot paper. That's why this Saturday, the feed encourages you to vote one, Dickenballs. Dickenballs is the only candidate that truly represents what Australians think about politics. Unlike the Coalition, Dickenballs actually has a proven track record on jobs and growth, sometimes as much as 4 inches. And unlike Labor, Dickenballs won't just legislate same-sex marriage, it'll consummate it. Now, the feed does acknowledge there are concerns about voting Dickenballs this election. Many worry whether the usually progressive Dickenballs is held hostage by his conservative right ball. And some doubt Dickenballs' ability to govern for women, even though we've already had a Dickenballs as Minister for Women.
But in a campaign that featured more rats than inspiring moments, do Australians really have a choice other than Dickenballs? Let's face it, a vote for the two major parties is a vote for Dickenballs anyway.
This election, you don't want a hung parliament, you want a well-hung parliament. Vote one, Dickenballs.